I want to read from the prophet Isaiah. For there's a word here that will enable us to face the future unafraid. In the 41st chapter of Isaiah, and the 41st chapter in the 8th and following verses, this is what we read. But thou, Israel, art my servant. Jacob, whom I have chosen, the seed of Abraham, my friend. We know the ethnicity of the Jewish people that is referred to here. But we thank God that Jesus came and revealed that the kingdom of God is far more vast than just an ethnic group of Jews occupying Palestine. Jesus came to declare that the kingdom is everywhere God rules. And so we discover that we who are believers in God through Jesus Christ are included as the people of God. We are God's chosen, along with those whom he chose to be the bearers of the light of the gospel to the whole world. And the seed of Abraham, those who are the sons and daughters who approach God through faith, that Jesus has revealed God to mankind. Thou whom I have taken from the ends of the earth and called thee from the chief men thereof and said unto thee, thou art my servant. How many here know that you are a servant of the Most High God? Amen. You are my servant. I have chosen thee and not cast thee away. In other words, God declares to those who love him, you belong to me. And that's what it really means to be holy, is to belong to God. And so listen to the 10th verse that was written especially for the first Sunday of 2017. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed. For I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yes, I will help thee. And he comes with another yes. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not overcome with disappointment and paralyzed by fear. For I am thy God. I will strengthen thee, yea, I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. This text, when embraced, will enable us to face whatever difficulty, whatever problem that we must face in 2017. It is important to note what really causes fear among God's people. What is the genesis of fear? Fear usually comes as a result of uncertainties around change. And how many here today would testify that some changes are going on in our world? There's changes in every sphere. The change in the dollar is not as much as it used to be. The political change in America has been unprecedented. The change from the Obama era to the Trump era offers some very profound and earth-shattering changes because of difference in philosophy and economics and values and spirituality. Whether we're ready for it or not, There's going to be a change in this country after the 21st of January. Profound changes. Thanks be to God. But we are ready for the change. There are changes in the international relationships. In the past, kings and presidents communicated through their ambassadors with each other. Now, the president of Russia and the president-elect of the U.S. are communicating by Twitter. It's a change. There's a change in the balance of power. There's a change in trade. When I was a boy, some 75, 80 years ago, if you saw something that had printed on it, made in China, you know it was cheap. And it wouldn't last long. But now China is among the nation's top nations in technology and inventions and production. And as a matter of fact, it is so successful in its venture that we are now really owned by China. And that creates a different change. But who has the money has the power. Change causes fear because one does not know what's going to happen as a result of the change. It is important to notice the life of Jesus with his disciples. He discovered that they were comfortable when he was in charge and empowered. But when it seemed that he was not demonstrating his power, they were overcome by fear. It was on the Sea of Galilee that an awful storm arose, and the disciples were frightened because the billows were blowing and the waves were dashing against the ship, and the ship was reeling and rocking. And they said, "Where's Jesus?" And they checked him out, and he was in the back of the boat, sleep on a pillow. How strange that Jesus would be sound asleep while the ship was about to go under. And they found him and they said, "Wake up, Jesus. Don't you care that we perish?" And Jesus got up from the sleep, wiped the sleep from his eyes, and declared to them, "Be still." Spoke to the waves, "Be still." Spoke to the wind, "Calm yourself." He spoke to his disciples and said, "Oh, you little faith, I'm a storm chaser. I'm able to speak peace in the midst of the storm." So he spoke to them and he calmed their fears. When Jesus was about to be arrested and to be tried at the hands of wicked men, his disciples saw the seriousness of the case, and they began to be overcome by fear. And Jesus spoke the words that are recorded in the 14th chapter of the Gospel of John. "Let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." And I believe that as we approach this season of change, profound change, change in the economy, change in the educational community, change in the government, change in every sphere of life, I hear the voice of Christ speaking to us. "Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also." Jesus speaks to his disciples at their moment of greatest fear, and he declares, "Peace be unto you." He calmed their fears and replaced their fears with faith. Someone has said rightly that fear knocked on my door, and I told faith to go with me to answer it. And when faith came to the door, there was nobody there. For fear cannot stand in the presence of faith. Faith believes the incredible. Faith sees the invisible. Faith believes that the impossible can be done by the power of God. Faith dispels fear. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. But 700 years before Jesus came, here Isaiah the prophet declares, fear not. Don't you be a scaredy cat. Don't you be afraid. Don't be afraid of what might happen, because God is never under any conditions. He's always on top of whatever it is. He's always in charge. This is thy Father's word. So it is today, my brothers and my sisters, as we begin a new year, the word from the Lord, the word from the prophet Isaiah, the word from Jesus is, fear not, for I am with thee. You know, it's important to know who's with you in a crisis. Many people have gone down to destruction because they thought somebody was with them who was not with them. How many know that if God says, I'm with you, he's with you? It doesn't matter what it looks like. It doesn't matter who's on the other side, for God is always in the majority. He said, fear not, because I'm with you. I'm with you to protect you. I'm with you to rebuke the devil. I'm with you to give you victory over self and Satan and sin. I'm here with you, and I'm with you all the way. I will never leave you. Fear not, because I'm with you. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. And to know that God is a reassuring. How many know that there are a lot of folks running around now trying to claim they're God? But they're not God. People want to threaten your safety and your well-being. They're not God. People who talk about how much power they have, they're not God, because their breath is in their nostrils and their life is in God's hands. There's nobody God but God. To tell your neighbor that. Fear not, for I'm with you. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. And listen to what God has promised to you. Personalize these promises. I will strengthen thee.
Yeah.
I will give you strength when your strength is about faded away. I will enable you to stand when you're about to sit down like other folk who's sitting down. I will give you strength for your struggles. And you, whatever the struggle is you're facing right now, God has promised this beginning of the new year, I will strengthen you. They that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. I will renew your strength. Yes. And when God speaks this yes, that means affirm it. Yes, I will help thee. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. And that's all the help we need for the change that we're facing. Now, there's another text that I want to leave with you, and I want you to commit these texts to memory. Isaiah 41 and 10. Don't be afraid because of the change and the uncertainty. Don't be afraid, because God is with us. And then in the same book, Isaiah 43, and 18. It's a good sound to hear the pages turning in church. Too bad we can't hear those cell phones. I know that there are those who are reading it from the cell phone. The 18th and 19th verses of the 43rd chapter of Isaiah. Remember ye not the former things. What the prophet is saying to the believer at the beginning of this year is that some things you need to forget.
Amen.
Don't bring a lot of this garbage and trash into the new year. This is a good time to have a burning party and get rid of some stuff. Remember not the former things.
Yes.
Don't dwell on the past mistakes. Don't dwell on the past failures. Don't dwell on the aborted dreams that frustrated you during 2016. Don't dwell on the shortcomings of folk who disappointed you. Don't remember the stuff that you ought to forget. Remember not the former things, neither consider the things of old, because this is a new day.
Yes.
2017 is a new day.
Yes.
And you can go to it, into it screaming and kicking, or you can surrender and say, Lord, here I am.
Yes.
Have your way. Use me, Lord, in your service. Take away the shame. Fill me with your grace. Restore my joy. Strengthen me for the task. Give me victory in the warfare. We can face it without fear, or we can struggle with remembering the past. Behold, that means look ahead. That's what that means. Behold, I will do a new thing. And God said, now you don't you be afraid, because I've got this. I can handle this. What is it that you've been disappointed before? Well, I can handle this. I can prepare your mind and your spirit. I can enable you to grasp the promises and take hold of the goodness of God and stand after you've done all to stand, just to stand anyhow. Behold, look here. I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. It shall spring forth. Shall you not know it? I will even make a way in the wilderness and rivers in the desert. God speaks through the prophet and says that there's no situation that's beyond my control. I will do a new thing. What is this new thing that God has promised to do in 2017? Let's apply it here to St. Stephen's and do our congregations where we worship. What is this new thing? God is going to restore the joy in the midst of his people. Do you remember the joy that you had when you first were saved? How you felt the excitement, and you told everybody you met about what the Lord had done. I was a drug addict, but I'm delivered. I was sick, but God healed me. I was always singing the blues, and nobody, my baby done left me. But now I'm singing glory, glory, hallelujah.
Amen.
because I laid my burden down. Behold, I will do a new thing. Now it shall spring forth. I'm going to do a new thing. I'm going to even bring you to the place where you come to church on time. That'll be a new thing.